Hello everyone, and welcome to this week's Reiki session. Today we're gonna do a video on our Leo season, since we finished our zodiac series in the previous format. This video will be in the newer type that I want to implement on my channel. If you really like it, let me know. It's still completely new to me, but when I planned it out, I was like filled with this burst of creativity and energy. So I thought, this is it. This is how it has to be. So we're gonna focus on three planets today that moved into this Leo season, and the other three, like the continuation of this video, will be posted on my Patreon, so you can check that out if you want even more Leo season content as well as the next zodiac signs. So I'm gonna specifically tell you which planet moves in which sign, which day. I'm gonna put it the date on here so that you know what we're talking about. The first one is gonna be a little bit some people might look forward to it, some might don't. We're gonna have a Venus retrograde starting July 22nd, ongoing until September 3rd. So it being in Leo season, we want to focus on letting go of old love stories and be our most authentic selves and be as much as self-aware as possible. So I'm gonna start with breaking up your energetic field and old energies from previous love stories, relationships that you had. Gonna remove them from your energetic field, do a plucking so that they're fully removed, that you can move on from them and be open for your next chapter in love. Sweep away the kind of like residue. I'm not only gonna focus on the camera, I'm gonna focus everywhere on your energetic body so that I'm completely sure that we have removed everything. You can also, when this retrograde starts, like the first day on July 22nd, just set the intention for the whole Venus retrograde that you release any old stories, any people that might still be an attachment or like kind of, I have this specific word in mind, but it's just, it does not want to come to me. But you know, you can already set like kind of like the mood as well for it. You can also write letters to these people just for yourself and just, I don't know, rip it up, burn it. Whatever helps you move completely on and say, okay, this is it. something I have also learned from one of the spiritual creators that I follow. She said you can also do a cord cutting yourself by just saying that you want to release this soul contract you have with this person. You on your part have learned all your lessons that you needed, so therefore there's no need for this soul contract to still be there. And with that, on the finishing note saying you release them with love and light, and then it's just done. It's actually so easy for people who sometimes like to overcomplicate things or like we don't think so deep and beyond that it's just like just a few words are needed. Next, we focus on your being authentic and more self-aware with this carnelian. gonna focus here with the crystal as well over your root chakra. Next is Mars in Virgo, and it transits into Virgo July 10th, which is today where it's being built. And one point is self-improvement. It's a really big theme. It's a time where we can just work on ourselves. So I want to amplify that first. And that same planet. Another important thing is prioritizing your rest. Use this Lipidia light to help us out. So I love not only resting, but taking time to spend with your loved ones as a form of relaxation as well. Something, a word that was really highlighted was play. So just really being playful during that time, having fun. Another thing as well is remove any stress from work. Just gonna ground your energy. And slowly sending that stressful and anxious energy down into the ground so you can release it. We then have Mercury that moves into Leo on July 11th. We're gonna here bring our creative side more forward. The vibe here is being more creative and doing your hobbies as a way to refresh yourself. Another energy that was really present is lazy afternoons. Lazy, thrown loosely around because it's just as well as relaxing, but just calmer afternoons where you just don't stress through anything at all. Just move a little bit more slowly through your day, afternoon, whenever you see this. Just take it as a chance and time to just be a few, to help you tone it down. There we go. That took way too long. I'm even not gonna cut it out because I'm human. My brain functions sometimes a little bit faster, sometimes a little slower. So, you know, I feel like it fits to it. Like, it just shut down, basically. But yeah, just, you know, whatever being lazy means to you. For me, it means sometimes to just sit on the bed and either watch an ASMR video from this one creator that I really like, or reading a book, just like just be immersed in that book without anything else to think about because you're just so pulled in. That's only kind of like to hypnotize you to just be like, oh, I can be lazy today and nothing can make me feel guilty. Oftentimes people, when they think they're being lazy, they feel guilty because someone out there told them taking rest for themselves is being lazy. But no, you're just taking care of yourself. Finish this with an aura. Now you're fully ready to prance around the Leo season. Thank you so much for being here with me and letting me be a part of this, sharing your path with me. Until the next time, stay healthy and safe. Goodbye, my friends.